let's break the world by making the strongest nation every single year disappear. Like a Thanos snap just to eliminate them and maybe give chances to other people. This is gonna be complete just disgustingness, I think, by the end of it. We have this nice handy-dandy ranking system, and surprisingly, Russia is number one. I don't know how that's going on. Well, they're not gonna be for much longer. Actually, all of these nations are only gonna be around for a little bit. Every January 1st, I'm gonna be deleting an entire country, just cause it's fun. Don't worry about the people and what happens to them. We're not gonna, nah, the consequences aren't a big deal. So I guess we're starting with Russia. Let's go, I guess. I really didn't expect this. So with them gone, all these surrounding nations have the opportunity to recolonize this land and maybe have a chance of getting really powerful. Don't get too powerful though. That'd probably be the opposite of what you wanna do here. Doesn't really matter what happens to the US because they're next up on the chopping block. So just chill, don't even do anything. I mean, I guess you could try to take out Syrup Land, but what's the point? By the way, loving this new version of Greenland. Really prefer this name instead. Now, depending on how long we go for, we could see like a really tiny place end up just dominating, like Cyprus or something. I don't even know, Albania, someone over here. Your time has come. I'm sorry you've done, well, you've done nothing, but okay. Luckily there's like, what, over 100 nations, 200 nations, something like that. So we could go on for a while and this should still work. I don't even know who's next. Who's next? India. Okay, India, China, France is pretty high. Wow, oh, a lot of Europeans coming up. Oh, that's sad. India was involved in a bunch of conflicts and they were trying to grow. Actually, they lost something, surprisingly. Well, it doesn't matter, goodbye. Oh, good, good. People are starting to colonize and it's time for the true, oh, that's Portugal. Never mind, what? What are you guys doing? I thought the supreme ruler was getting stuff back. He actually might be in that perfect like middle spot. Like that's what you want to be. You want to be like that middle tier nation. That way you don't get too powerful, but you slowly grow. And oh, yep, America's being colonized too. Why am I not surprised? Not surprised at all. Next is China. And I promise I did delete China, but I guess when you do that, someone else becomes China. That is amazing. I love that little detail. I had no idea that happens. That's really cool to me. And they got some interesting allies too. Ah, and I see Spain is over here trying to take back some old colonies. Come on, leave the Philippines alone. They've been through enough. Couple little conflicts going on back in Europe, which it doesn't really matter because a lot of you guys are getting deleted soon. So, you know, I guess have your fun for now because you're about to be in purgatory. Ah, France, you've surrendered for the final time. Yep. Time's up. A whole lot of nations around here definitely trying to do a whole like little Raj thing. Man, this is a big, big old mixture. Everyone's getting a little piece of that. Oh, this is kind of terrifying. Please do not give the Mongolians this much open space. We've seen what happened last time. Honestly, best case scenario for these countries is to start losing a bunch of wars. Like if you see yourself in the top eight, just get a big old coalition to declare on you and lose a bunch of land, which might be exactly what Germany's doing. Never put past Germany and what they'll do to take over the world. Oh my goodness, Albania is now currently in Indochina. I thought this was the British. I was gonna give them crap for that, but nope, Albanians, they're out here colonizing. So is Morocco, I guess, and Romania. Fantastic. And we now got some random islands out here colonizing the tip of Texas. They just, you know, just the tip. Wow, absolutely terrible idea to do the Anschluss right now. That was not the right move. I'm just trying to figure out like who's got the best chance of making it out alive, because I mean so many people are going down. I know Brazil's probably gonna come up, Mexico soon, Canada. Yeah, so I don't know exactly. Maybe Japan? Japan's been lying low. Actually, or maybe the Saudis. This is like the best case for them, just to lose a little bit of land, but chill, stay alive. I don't know if they are gonna stay alive because they're really struggling though. Oh, actually, I really like Benelux's chances. Anyone here, maybe even Luxembourg. Luxembourg would definitely win this if we go on far enough. And Ireland has been saved. They were literally losing like a bunch of conflicts, but now they're good. Oh, they gotta watch for Belgium though. Belgium's already trying to take over. Damn waffle people. And now currently, North America is almost completely unpopulated. But I don't know what happened here. Can someone explain to me why the US is back? And can some nations come back? Now, were there like colonists out at sea that didn't get deleted and then they slowly rebuilt? If that's the case, this is gonna make it even more exciting. Like maybe Great Britain can come back in a few years, although I don't know if that's a good idea. You probably won't get your island back. And South America is looking pretty up in the air too, with the biggest power now being eliminated, actually the first power. So anyone can really go after this, just don't take too much stuff. Oh no. Poland's been forced to disappear so many times, I don't wanna have to do it too. Oh dang, Australia is actually ranked. I wasn't sure, Australia was really quiet for a while, but I guess, yeah, as we continue to delete people, there's only a higher chance they're going to come up. Indonesia's just getting ravaged right now, so they might fall in the rankings a little bit, but they got a lot of islands. They need to start losing stuff fast. Europe's pretty wide open. The only ones that's, like, I guess really taking advantage of the situation is, like, Portugal, Morocco, a little bit of Irish people, and then Belgium. No one else. No, Belgium, you leave Luxembourg alone. I thought this was gonna be their chance. They're getting sieged. Please, Dutch, save them. I just cannot believe the US is back. How did that happen? They have Florida, so they got the strongest of military men. Who's that? Is that Denmark? Denmark, can you stop it? Why? Always, you're always over here. Man, the Southern Hemisphere nations are probably so happy right now. Look at that. They're like really the only ones left. Everyone from the north is getting taken out. Egypt's over here colonizing, like just north of Korea. We also have Portugal. Bad idea. Portugal's not going to make it much longer. Turkey flew a little too close to the sun, and there they go. Wait, I don't even know if turkeys can fly. I don't think they can. Ooh, Vinland is making a comeback. I like that. And they've been merged. So that merge, Denmark doing great things, I guess. Weirdly, people are still following faith in a situation like this, even though millions of people are disappearing every year. Well, actually, maybe that would be the reason why they do that. Did not expect you guys to be so high up there. So, all right, Sweden has dodged a bullet for now. This island nation really knows what they're doing, I guess. They're going straight after everything. No one else is really trying. Oh, US has already got California and Oregon back, though. And the Irish have united. So they've got their entire island back, and we got some, like, blue people who, wait, who are you? Iceland. Oh, I love that. Look at this, Europe, it is just depressing. Still some conflicts going on, so they're traveling through the unoccupied forests and things like that to go after their enemies. You thought Indonesia was just disgusting before. Now there is no Indonesia, and everyone's just gonna be able to get a little piece of that. Who are all these people? We got Slovenia over here, the Philippines, not going too far for that. Romania, wow, Romania getting a lot. Oh, certain nations are popping up out of the uncolonized territory. I think that's what's happening, because sometimes this game does that. I think that's how the US randomly, magically kind of popped up. So I think that confirms that some places can make a comeback. I don't really know how that happens though, but yeah, I just saw it before my eyes. So it comes to this. We've got like the Balkans and a lot of other Eastern Europeans. They can really take a lot, but just, you know, kind of chill. Ah, I'm sad. The time has come. I'm so sorry, Belgium. Oh no, the US is starting to get a little bit too powerful. They've ranked again. They've got 8 years. Look at this though, Peru managed to be number one. That's how you know things are getting funky. Oh, this is messed up. Africa is completely untouched. They are completely fine. This is basically just coming down to delete everyone except this continent. That is terrible. I actually did not expect them, but they're not colonizing. They're not colonizing, which is the problem. Oh man, this makes me sad. Look how amazing Latvia is doing. I really like this, but I'm gonna have to destroy you soon. This is just sad. Like, this is like kicking someone when they're already down. Gotta delete the US again. Oh, what a great comeback. It's actually just fun to see this like teeter back and forth. The Dutch were just number one, but then Morocco colonized something and now they're top, you know, a little higher. Australia's been doing a good job of doing nothing, and that's exactly what they need to do. Just do nothing, chill with your deserts and terrifying insects and creatures and things like that, and you'll be okay. Look how just terrible this part of the world looks. So much border gore. It's bad. It is really bad. Oh, look, and Korea united without anyone realizing it. I don't even know who united Korea. That's sad. I want to know. It's just regular old school Korea now too, so I don't know. Oh man, it might have been the north. Is that the north? It probably was, because normally US guarantees their independence, but without their existence, they didn't have anyone to protect them. Yeah, this part of the map is just super active. I now took out Norway and they're still going on. There's still like more people, Finland still doing stuff. But yeah, a lot of things happening in like Nordic countries. There you go, Ireland, do your thing. At least get everything back before I have to delete you. That'd be good. And there they go. Okay, well, you tried for a little bit, but yeah. Now New Zealand is looking actually pretty nice. Just, you know, do your thing. Basically, this game is rewarding for the first time ever nations that don't do anything. And I hate those places for the most part, but this is now the time to do that. Egypt, you're doing way too much, my brother. That's a bad move. Oh my goodness, look who just made a comeback. Okay, and you know what? They made a comeback because I just had to delete Denmark. Sorry, Denmark. But they had a colony, they had Vinland. That means they got their independence. So Canada's back, and maybe that's how, that is how it happened. Oh, the US came back because the British colonized Florida. I deleted the British. Ah, that makes sense. Now, the problem for a lot of these other places is they're not creating colonies. They're actually taking this land for themselves. So unless you're creating actual new nations, we're not gonna see places come back all that often. No, please, don't make me do it. Don't make me do it, I love you. Amazingly though, Germany is now back, which I think Germany might have gone, I think they kind of popped out of the land and the Swiss were gonna take him out too, so maybe this will give him a chance. They got a couple years of survival. Well, you guys definitely didn't get as far as I wanted, but at least you kind of got Scotland back. That's good, RIP. How is Canada already number one? They just have Greenland and Newfoundland. I guess because the bar is so low, like we have to just delete everyone. Russia's also over here now, just chilling when I don't know. I can't explain all this. Man, they're looking good though. I can't believe this, but the actual winners are probably gonna be island nations in Oceania. They're like so chill. Cyprus is doing stuff. Can't even like, I can't remember where they start from. Oh, maybe they lost their main island. They moved their capital at least. Okay, sorry. I can't believe it. I've got to take them out now. I just deleted Russia. Look at that. I just deleted that other Russia. Oh wait, no, I'm sorry. I thought I was getting confused. They're getting close. They're getting really close. Nigeria's been near the top for so long, but then someone comes out of nowhere. Croatia, look at Croatia. Someone comes out of nowhere and like takes their spot. Croatia doesn't even look that big. We are really getting down to like the nitty gritty. Look at South Africa just slowly taking out places. They're doing good. That was actually a couple places. Ethiopia doing pretty nice too. And it's now been officially 40 years of deleting nations. I'm gonna go ahead and stop now. I just love how fast the game's running now. This is a great idea. Now we can actually speed through it and see what happens. Who in the hell is Vestfold? What is Vestfold? I've never heard of that nation in my life, and they're out here just taking everything, even Southern Ireland. Oh no, China's making a comeback. China's out here retaking a lot of stuff, even though there's other people that, now Japan decides to strike. So smart. I knew it. I knew this was gonna happen. You can't, you just can't put anything past them. Anime land, they smart. Oh, some other ones doing pretty good too. Thought Mongolia would be a little bit higher, but yeah, not a bad top eight. Obviously this didn't change too much, even though I guess it should. I don't really know. There's no HRE or anything like that. And some other things. Let me know if you want to see more. Maybe I can come back and do every like 10 years or every 100 years, something like that. I liked using this modern day map though, because there's more nations and bigger impacts can happen, obviously. But anyways, thanks for watching. See you next time.
And thanks again
to Seth L.
Ballin' Like Stalin.
Mega Fat Boy 2.0.
Tyler Beach.
A. Mikey.
Bolovsky.
Three Cruz.
All Night.
Birthday Daddy.
Sleeper 56.
Militime.
Brandon H.
Gooder Donkey.
Pizza.
Maxi G.
Swiss Argo.
Boosterification.
Elijah Senpai.
And Elfie C.